Hi guys, and welcome to my quick and mini review about the Brown Sisters. So I read this book, Get a Life, Carly Brown, and fell in love with it and adored it and gave it out to people, and I really liked it. I thought it was really, really cute. So I decided to read all the series, and this is where I'm just going to review them real quick. Okay, so the first one is Get a Life, Chloe Brown by Tali Hibbert, and this one is about this curvaceous, beautiful girl who is chronically ill, and the struggle is real, but she has a big awakening when she almost dies. So she decides to go home, and she writes out this powerful list of all the things she wants to do in her life, and it forces her outdoors, basically. She doesn't have very much physical strength at all, but it pushes her a little bit in that way. And then this is a guy who's like the maintenance man at the apartment. But, you know, he's got a lot more going on than being a maintenance man. And so they bump into each other and she thinks he doesn't like her at all. But he's actually pretty into her and like is kind of interested and keeps on digging is the way I take it. But she does recognize that he's very, very cute looking. But I thought the story was so well done. I thought it was funny. It's good when you read a romantic comedy. I thought it was really, really cute. And so I went on to read the other two. So this one I love. I bought it right away and put it on my shelves. And there's not enough good things I could say about this one. I thought the coupling was really good done. I thought they were dynamic and interesting. And I thought the plot had a good storyline with her almost dying and then her pushing herself to do all these things and how he would help her. It wasn't like they were shoved together or pushed together. I hate those scenarios, and especially when they don't work out. It was just him genuinely wanting to help her. And so I really like that. I really enjoyed that about this novel, that it was a believable storyline. I really, really did like that. It's Take a Hint, Danny Brown by Talia Hibbert. And this one is about Danica and Zafir. I cannot say his name right at all, but it's got this beautiful yellow cover and I was so excited for it. It is also a cute romantic comedy as well. It's about this woman who is a strong professor and she dyes her hair all these crazy colors, her short hair, and then this guy who is a security guard at the front desk, which he used to be a pro soccer player. They call it football in my book, but yeah, a soccer player. And he's got serious anxiety issues. And so the storyline is kind of not very plot driven, I didn't think as much. And in this book, I didn't feel like the characters developed all that well, but what she did get right again was the romance, the comedy. I really enjoyed that one. So I decided not to give, I think the first one I gave 5 stars. I think this is more of a 3.5 star just because the plot wasn't as deep there, and as well as with the problem with the plot was it was propped up by this social media timeline plot and it was felt unnecessarily pushed in there. I didn't quite believe the social media. I could believe it a little bit, but it just seemed unnecessary to everything else that was going on in the story. And so it just kind of took hits away from the romance that was going on and the cute couple themselves. And their backgrounds are so, I feel like they prop themselves up so much in this book, where this book it really wasn't so much about their backgrounds. These were just like two people and how they connect, where this one was a lot more about their backgrounds. And so I don't know, there was just something off about it that I didn't love as the characters and the storyline as a whole, and so I didn't love this one as much, but still fun and a great series. Still like, oh yeah, I want to read about the last sister. Which was After Age, Eve Brown by Talia Hibbert. And this one, so cute. This girl has purple hair as well, the last sister. She is shorter. And then this one does start with a really cute storyline, just like the first one, where she like almost runs over this guy that she just interviewed with. Her parents have pushed her out of the house, trying to get her to do something to motivate her, because every time she tries to do something, she fails and doesn't go through with it, which is a story I think a lot of people know. But it is about two people that are on the spectrum too, which was an interesting story. This one was a little different from the other two, where the other two you knew they were attracted to each other right away. This one had a bit of a slow burn, and this one had an interesting jump start. But unlike Chloe Brown, I thought this one, Eve Brown, got a little sloggy in the middle. Where it had a good jump start, like this girl's like redefining herself and getting a new job, and she hit this guy that's like very, very particular about everything. But the middle kind of slogged for me, and so I wasn't nearly as excited for it once I was finishing and wrapping up. I just was wanting to get to that ending because I wasn't enjoying the storyline as much. As well as Jacob, he just seems like a hero you don't love. Like, he is so grumpy through most of it, but it isn't that grumpiness, or he doesn't come off in that way that you want to love him still. You're just like, he's annoying, like grumpy. So I didn't love this one as much either. I'd say this is about a 3.5. If I had read one of these two books, I probably would have been like, oh, I like that author's writing, I'll pick up another one of hers. But I didn't love these books. I just really loved the first one. So those are my thoughts on the the Brown Sister series. I wonder what you guys were thinking about them too, whether you really enjoyed them. I know these books are hugely hyped up on TikTok and here on YouTube, so just let me know how you felt about them. I really enjoyed the first one, and the other two were just okay. They weren't take it or leave them books. Like, I still really enjoyed them. It's just there was some issues with the stories and the characters that I didn't love them. So I'll see you guys in the next one. See you guys next time. Bye!